We are going to talk about PowerPoint Designer. It's an AI feature which is available right now. I know there is a lot of talk about Copilot, but it is yet to be released. So let's dive straight into PowerPoint. But now, let's start using that Designer button. Now you'll say, I'm already using it. I click on that button and I get everything. I agree, but there is much more to it than just clicking. So let's start with the simplest but the most powerful way of using Designer. Create a blank new presentation, one slide, title slide, and put the keyword or phrase for which you are intending to create the presentation. Now click on the Designer button. And what you get is not just a visual with a video or a nicely designed first slide. It looks at the first visual and automatically adjusts the color scheme and fonts, layout. So additional slides which you will put in that PPT are coordinated from a design point of view. So it gives you a design theme-based template. That's the best way to use Designer from scratch. Now, of course, every day you're not creating new PPTs. In that case, you go on a per-slide basis. By the way, Designer is on by default, and as soon as you type and click outside, it may give you design ideas. Initially, it's an exciting thing, but in real life, that's irritating. So you switch it off and only use it on demand. How do you switch it off? Go to File Options, go to this option and disable it. Disable in the sense it will not come automatically. That button still works. Now, when we talk about individual slides, typically we have text, bullets, numbering, charts or tables. So usually it works on photos and text. So let's talk about photos first. You can put up to 5 photos and it'll automatically organize them. It will give you options and you choose the one you want. Generally, it tries to crop intelligently by looking at what is in the picture, but sometimes you have to adjust. When it comes to text, it has many capabilities depending on what text you are typing. So broadly, 2 types. One is communicating large numbers. For example, I have written here, when you use Office or PowerPoint very well, you're going to save this much time. That time I have put in minutes, that's a large number. Even if I know exactly what I'm talking about, how much time is that is difficult to assess. And why would you want to confuse the audience? You would want them to have clarity rather than confusion. And that is called perspectives. So just click on the button and you'll be surprised. It has actually done the calculation and now it has converted it to a phrase which is easy to understand. I'm not removing the large number. I'm making it simpler to understand. Let's take some other examples. This is about height. This one is about calories. This is about money. So it understands various types of measurements and does a good job. In Word also, this feature is there. In fact, you may have noticed that while you're writing something, a blue dashed line appears. That's not a spelling mistake. That's not a grammatical mistake. That's a perspective. So click on it. It will give you an equivalent, simpler way to communicate that number. Coming back to our topic, now let's talk about text itself. So let's see one by one. So I have this list. It looks like a timeline to me because there is a year and what happened in that year. One click is going to give you a timeline. Not just one, it'll give you variations of timeline. Okay, you chose one, add it, great. Now, afterwards, after 2 months, you want to add one more item there. You don't have to add a shape and copy paste. You click on it, it's a smart art. What does that mean? On the left side, there is an arrow. Open that editor, add a new item there, and it'll expand automatically. Now, if you go to Smart Art, Insert Smart Art, it's not going to show you this Smart Art. So these are special Smart Arts which are dynamically generated. That's the only way to get it through Designer. Now, talking about videos, very often it will give you video suggestions. Now, you will say video is great, but video typically increases file size. So is that a disadvantage? No. Usually, videos which are inserted by Design Ideas come from Microsoft's library of videos, which is again a very high quality curated library with a special feature. What is the special feature? These videos are designed to be used as backgrounds or illustrations in PowerPoint. More importantly, backgrounds. And because it's a background, it may last for a long time. The same slide may run for an indefinite amount of time. Now, if video is long, file size increases. So these are short videos, but they are designed in such a way that they loop. That means you keep the slide on, it repeats itself, but you will never know where it ended and where it started. The first and last frame is same. All videos in the video library are like that. By now you must be understanding, before you go searching for any video or a picture outside, try Microsoft's library. It is a great collection and will give you better quality output faster. Don't just wait for designer to give you those ideas. You can also directly go and search. And that is copyright free. Going and doing search outside may expose you to litigation risk as well. It's very simple. Just go to insert, pictures, stock images, and you have so many categories. Just choose what you want and you get better impact. Now let's take another example. These are simple bullets, no timeline, but it's still going to find the correct icon. Sometimes the icon may not be the one you wanted. No problem. Click on the icon and it'll show you replay suggestions right there. One important thing. In those bullets, if there is a mention of a person, people, anything human, generally it does not give you an icon and you will just get boxes. So if it doesn't recognize for some reason, then it will get just be a simple smart art. If it understands, then it will be smart art with icons. Obviously, smart art with icon looks better, but it may not always be available. Now, here is an example. This is a list I took on how to fire a person. This is from HBR. Now, I want those icons, but it's not giving me icons. It's just giving me a simple smart art. Now, how do I handle that situation? Everyone who has used Designer has gone through this. Now, you have to start thinking about how AI works. What is it trying to do? Understand what you are trying to say. Convert that into a single keyword and do some kind of search for graphics. Now, it's not working. So, you can help AI. Remember, our natural intelligence is better than artificial intelligence. Just make a duplicate of that slide. And then, for every phrase we have written, just find a keyword which logically will make sense and hopefully Microsoft will find it in the library. So, convert that bulleted list into a small list of tokens or suggestions or stimulus to that AI. And generally, it will create a smart art with icons. Now, once you have that, there is another problem. Even if it is a template, the suggested slide doesn't look like your slides very often. What do you do then? Just insert it and then copy the smart art, put it into a new slide as per your template. Now you get best of both worlds. It's a little lengthy way of doing it, but once you get used to it, it's a lifesaver. Oh, by the way, in Word, there is a feature where an entire Word document, if you open it on browser, can be converted to PowerPoint directly. That feature uses design ideas behind the scenes. Have a look at this video for details. Now, let's do some troubleshooting because Designer doesn't always work. Biggest problem is I don't have the Designer button itself. Oh, that means you don't have the subscription or Office Pro Plus version of Office. If you have that, you get the button. Simple. If you don't see it on the desktop and you have Office 365 subscription, you can also find it in the browser version of PowerPoint. Now, sometimes the Designer button is there, but it is disabled. Why would that happen? First thing is, all this requires an internet connection. So if you don't have internet, Designer won't work. Simple. But other common reason is the way the current slide is not compatible with what Designer needs. Another situation is you have a proper layout, but on top of that layout, you have added your own text boxes or shapes or objects, then again, Designer may not work. I am sure, even if you have been using Designer, you must have got some extra ideas and knowledge. So try it out. Let me know if it works for you. Put your queries. Your ideas for more videos are also welcome. And share this with your team as well. Subscribe, bell icon, I'm sure you do already. Now, before you go, I have two popular videos about PowerPoint. Have a look at them as well. But that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.